හැබ්ලොක් ස්පෝර්ට්ස් ක්ලබ් එකත් එක්ක අවුරුදු 109ක ප්‍රෞඩ ඉතිහාසයක් තියෙන රග්බි ක්ලබ් එකක් එක්ක අපි එකතු වෙලා තිනවා. දුරදක්නා නුවණත් එක්ක මේ රග්බි ක්‍රීඩාව පමණක් නෙමෙයි රග්බි ක්‍රීඩාවෙන් ජීවිතේ ජය ගන්න පුළුවන් අඩිතාලමක් අත්විවරමක් ලබා දෙන්නයි.
Back something to the game, and he wanted the younger generation of this country to have a base in Australia. He's been having a study and make it something different. Flown down from Australia in the academy, and my academy, which is run
one particular group or one particular club or school. So that is my vision, and I think this maybe will be the breeding ground for the good rugby players with the exposure for the from international coaches and panel, and give more exposure to the players when they go out in the life to get a better opportunity outside this world, where we will create the bridge between the clubs. And from Australia to New Zealand, we want to make players exchange, come here, they go to Australia, come to New Zealand, with the support of from Kruger and his crew in New Zealand and Australia, which we are planning to do within next couple of years or maybe even next year. So that kind of exposure being given from the younger age, I'm definitely guarantee there will be a different breed of rugby players will be built in this country, which has been exposed to the overseas. We always watch how good the All Blacks are playing. That if we can bring them to the ground and be with them and give the exposure, how they do, what is the difference, how we are doing here, and that will be the finer point that is missing in Sri Lanka. Not that we don't have good players, definitely we have very good players. How do we make them better players? Is, I believe it will be done by Kruger and his team that is going to be in a panel. So I will make it short, and I think to Sri Lanka. So I will hope everybody will support us.
Gentlemen, thank you for come to Havelock Sports Club. And also I welcome current rugby union head, Mr. Nalin Silva also, and welcome Roche and the Fly High management team. So for people who doesn't know Cedric, I must also highlight a little fact about his involvement in sports. So he's been nicknamed as the godfather of Indo cricket. He's the founder of Austasia Indo cricket academy, and you know how Indo cricket is now in Sri Lanka. It's grown tremendously well. So he's the guy who was behind it like 20-25 years ago. So I'm so happy that he partnered with Havelock Sports Club to launch this academy. As you know, as a founder club, we are proud to announce that we are the first club to have this on board as an academy. So when Cedric came to us three seasons ago, he was mainly a first team sponsor. So then while he was patronizing the club, he gave this idea of having an academy and how we can help his team to build a junior academy at Havelocks. And Tusita was part of the discussion, as he was also our immediate past president before me. So for us, basically our main objective is to see, we are launching our first practice session on the 6th. That team will be basically, mostly will be 10-year-olds. So we want that 10-year-old kid who walks into our club next Saturday to play for Havelocks, give him a Havelocks contract in 10 years' time. So that's our long-term goal. That's why we have signed the contract with Fly High for 10 years, so that we can keep improving that individual child to become a national level player. So as I think to start with, we are going to go with 10, 12 and 14 year olds. So when they grow and they become 16-year-olds, we'll try and improve another team to that level. So that's our main goal, to have a Havelock's junior from the club. I'm talking about the club's perspective. So what we want is to have junior Havelock's players growing to be our main team players. So that's our goal from our side when we said yes to Cedric. As Susita mentioned, the most difficult part is the funding side of it, which I'm happy to say Cedric has covered that for us. And also he's covering part of our main team as well. He will continue to do that. And I thank Cedric for that. And I welcome Mr. Roach to this project. And hopefully we'll see him more of Net Havelock's in the coming years. So we welcome him to Havelock's. And as Cedric informed, he's been a key player in New South Wales rugby for junior and senior rugby coaching. And for the record, your son is playing still, right?
For sure.
Yeah, his son is a current Wallaby player. He's already touring. He's in the sevens, right? Yes. So his son is also a Wallaby player. So I'll leave it at that since we have a Q&A session. If you all want to clarify anything about the project, so we all of us are willing to clarify it for you. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody. My name is Kruger Roach. And yes, just very, very fortunate. My son is tomorrow on his way to his second Olympics, which is very, very grateful, at 22, which is not too bad. However, I didn't, you know, just a little bit of a background. Why did I start an academy back in and got involved in rugby? I've never ever been someone that wanted to coach. However, there's a lot of kids are missing out. There's so much talent that are missing out in Australia, which is pretty sad, but this is where the majority of the rugby community comes from, private school. So if you're not fortunate enough to have the money to go to that or get a scholarship, you probably won't be looked at unless you're absolutely amazing talent. But then they cater for rugby league. So this is where rugby league comes and swoops in everybody. So my whole purpose of what I've done is how to develop a player who has the need and the want to train. And this is where I don't believe I'm coming to teach any of the Sri Lankans anything new. I apologize, because I think the resources are already in here. We just got to utilize it and manage it a little bit better. And think, you know, because why? We can't teach Sri Lankans how to play like Fijians, because they don't. They can't teach them how to play like All Blacks, because they don't. They have their own individuality. They have their own strength. And my whole role is to come and dig that out. And for me, as a coach, my philosophy as a coach is one brain, two brains is better than one. And a lot of us have coaches as individuals. Every club, I've gone to a new club this year. Every club I coach or I'm involved in, is I get the collaboration of coaches. And I'm telling you now, once we drop that guard of, oh no, I'm better than you and you're better than me, but we come in together as a team, and that's what I see Cedric bringing into this. We're coming together for the best better of the game. So if we come and work in together, we're going to have a Q&A if there's anything else. But, you know, it's an amazing that Sri Lanka has 150 years of rugby. Havelock has 109 years in rugby. So there's nothing new to be learned. You guys have played in Hong Kong Sevens. Yes, things have happened and that sort of knocked on the way, but you were there. So there's nothing new to come. I think totally just putting in together, working from the young, and I love the age that we're working with, the 8, with the 10, 12, and 14s, because they're easily mold. So we can mold their little young brain, teach the basic, the fundamentals. I said, I think everybody I talked to, I said, I apologize on behalf of everybody. I'm going to be bored. You guys are going to be bored of my coaching style, because I just focus on the basics. You know, rugby is very basic, and too many people have complicated. And if we get a good pass on, get a strong run and a good tackle, you're halfway there. And that's where I'm hoping to come in and implement that. Just as some of the boys that I've coached, like I've got a kid who is now, he's the fly half for Tonga this week. So when I met him, he was 138 kilos, this kid. He was a big kid. He was in gangs and things like that, and he's only 21. And that's rugby has saved him. On the contrast, I've got another kid who's now got picked this week as well to be playing for Canada against Scotland in a couple of, in the coming week. And that's where all these young kids with, they didn't have the opportunity. All I took, when I took them in, is a brief belief into them. They were talented, but then just tweak the little basics that we do. So that's where I'm hoping to come. I'm super, super excited to be in Sri Lanka. I'm very grateful for Cedric to provide this opportunity to come. And if I can add my 1 cent in the rugby of Sri Lanka, then you know I'm very, very grateful. And just thank you for having me. Thank you.
මාධ්‍ය සහෝදරයන්ගෙන් අවසරයි මම හිතන්නේ අද fly high sports academy එක ලංකාවේ ප්‍රථම වතාවට ජාත්‍යන්තර වශයෙන් සහභාගීත්වයක් තියෙන rugby academy එකක් අපි Havelock sports club එකත් එක්ක අවුරුදු 109ක ප්‍රෞඩ ඉතිහාසයක් තියෙන rugby club එකක් එක්ක අපි එකතු වෙලා තිනවා fly high sports නිර්මාතෘ සෙඩ්‍රික් ඇන්තනි මහතාගේ දුරදක්නා නුවණත් එක්ක ඒ දාර්ශනිකයත් එක්ක මම හිතන්නේ මේ ඇකඩමි එක ක්‍රියේට් කරන්න ලොකුම අදහස ඇවිල්ලා ශ්‍රී ලාංකීය තරුණයන්ට තරුණයන්ට කුඩා දරුවන්ට මේ රග්බි ක්‍රීඩාව පමණක් නොවේ රග්බි ක්‍රීඩාවෙන් ජීවිතේ ජය ගන්න පුළුවන් අඩිතාලමක් අත්විවරමක් ලබා දෙන්නයි ගොඩක් කලාවට අපි හුදෙක් බලන්නේ රග්බි ක්‍රීඩාව එක්ක දිනම ප්‍රාචයට නැත්තම් රග්බි සමාජයක සාර්ථකත්වය ගැන විතරයි. හැබැයි රග්බි කියන ක්‍රීඩාවෙන් ඕනම ක්‍රීඩාවක් ගත්තොත් තාරුණ්‍යයට ජීවිතේ ජය ගන්න පුළුවන් අගනා ඉගෙන ගන්න පුළුවන් අවස්ථා රසක් තියෙනවා. මම හිතන්නේ ක්‍රූගරෝෂ් වගේ අග්‍රගන්නේ කෝච් කෙනෙක් එක්ක ඔහුගේ දැනුමත් එක්ක මේ රග්බි ස්ට්‍රක්චර් එකයි ඇකඩමි එක හරහා දැවන්ත සන්නාමයක් වෙන රග්බි ක්‍රීඩාවේ හැව්ලොක්ස් ක්‍රීඩා සමාජයත් එක්ක අපි එකතු වෙලා ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ තරුණයට යම්කිසි සුබලපෑමක් පොසිටිව් ඉම්පැක්ට් එකක් ක්‍රියේට් කරන්න හදනවා මේ ගේම් එක හරහා. ඉතින් අපි ඉතා කාරුණිකව ඉල්ලනවා අපේ මෞද්‍ය සෞද්‍යයන්ගෙන් මේ ගැන පබ්ලිසිටි එක ලබා දෙන්න කියලා. හේතුව ඇවිල්ලා මේක නැවතත් හැව්ලොක් සමාජයේ බ්‍රෑන්ඩිං වලටවත් ෆ්ලයි හයි ස්පෝර්ට්ස් රග්බි ඇකඩමි එකේ බ්‍රෑන්ඩිං වලටවත් විතරක් නෙමෙයි මං හිතන්නේ රටේ බ්‍රෑන්ඩිං වලට අගන අවස්ථාවක් රටේ රග්බි ක්‍රීඩාවට අගන අවස්ථාවක් වෙනතර වගේම රග්බි ක්‍රීඩාවට ආදරය කරන අපේ මාධ්‍ය සහෝදරයාගෙන් අපි අයිමත් ස්තුතිවන්ත වෙන ගමන්ම කාරුණික ඉල්ලනවා අපිට මේකට තියෙන පුළුවන් තරම් පබ්ලිසිටි එක ලබා දෙන්න කියලා. එතකොට අපිට හැම යවුණ ක්‍රීඩකයෙක්ටම අගනා අවස්ථාවක් ලබා දෙන්න පුළුවන් මේකෙන් ප්‍රයෝජනයක් ගන්න. බොහොමත්ම ස්තුතියි. කුඩා කාලේ ඉඳන්ම අවුරුදු 9ක් 10ක් ඉඳන් ප්‍රථමයෙන්ම මම හිතන්නේ ප්‍රථම වර්ෂයේ අවුරුදු 16 වෙනකන් අපි 14 වෙනකන් සමවෙන්න අපි ඊළඟ ලෙවල් එකට යන්න මේ මුලින්ම පටන් ගද්දී පොඩිම කාලේ ටිකක් ලේසි ඒගොල්ලන්ට අපිට අයන්න අයන්න කියලා දෙන්න පුළුවන් රග්බි ගේම් එකේ. ඊට පස්සේ ඒගොල්ලන්ව ඉහළ ස්තරයකට ගෙනියන්න තමයි අපේ ආදාසෝ.